Bacterial infections, we've really been lucky in the last century that we've discovered a whole range of antibiotics, and this has revolutionised medicine. However, in the last sort of two decades, we're getting this increasing problem of antimicrobial resistance. Now we have bacteria that infect us that we can't treat with any antibiotics we currently have. And this is one of the largest problems facing the planet today.
We have about 10 million new cases of tuberculosis in the world each year, which is one of the leading causes of death by a single bacterium worldwide. Now that is very confronting, considering that we've known this disease for more than 100 years. It has become apparent that more and more tuberculosis cases are resistant to one or multiple antibiotics that are currently used for treatment. So this makes treatment very difficult.
What we are doing is characterizing how these drugs act for killing the bacterium and how the bacterium can become resistant to these drugs. In this way, it will be possible to synthesize new drugs that will be able to better target that specific bacterium.
What we've found is that some patients actually overproduce a specific antibody. Now, antibody is usually good for you, but in this case, the antibody actually protects the bacteria. And we've treated patients by removing that particular antibody, and that allows their immune system to once again kill these bacteria, and they're able to actually leave the hospital and return home.
If we better understand how the immune system controls the infection, we perhaps are able to harness this knowledge to support the immune system in fighting an infection.
Actually seeing our research get translated to the clinic and actually help these patients and allow them to return home and get better was absolutely amazing. So what we hope is that this can extend out to multiple different types of bacteria that cause infection and allow the immune system to attack their own bacteria again.
One day maybe we can discover a new drug that will be able to better target the bacterium causing tuberculosis, the infectious disease.